The 1982 movie Dragon Lord had a sequence where Jackie was supposed to kick a feathered shuttlecock in one continuous moment. Jackie decided to shoot the acrobatic action sequence in one continuous shot, and it took 2,900 takes and over 40 days to get that perfect shot. Neil Armstrong had to fill an immigration form while coming back to the Earth from the Moon. Wim Hof is nicknamed the Iceman because he has the ability to withstand extreme cold. He climbed to 6.7 kilometers, 22,000 feet altitude at Mount Everest wearing nothing but shorts and shoes. He also ran a full marathon 42 kilometers above the Arctic Circle in minus 20 degrees Celsius in nothing but shorts. He holds the Guinness World Record by staying immersed in ice for 1 hour 52 minutes and 42 seconds. When his teammate died on the pitch due cardiac arrest, Italian footballer Antonio Di Natale took financial responsibility of his disabled sister, as his teammate was her only living relative left. Secret Service paid cybercriminal Albert Gonzalez $75,000 per year salary to act as an informant, while he simultaneously ran his own multi-million dollar credit card fraud empire. There is a sport called banzai skydiving. You throw the parachute out of the airplane first and then jump after it. During World War II in Australia, there was a dog whose hearing was so acute that it could warn Air Force personnel of incoming Japanese planes 20 minutes before they arrived, and before they showed up on radar. Gunner could also differentiate the sounds of allied and enemy aircraft. In 2009, a parrot named Willie noticed that the toddler his owner was babysitting was not okay. Willie raised the alarm by flapping her wings and yelling, "Mama baby." Megan, the owner, dashed into the room and found the baby choking and immediately performed the Heimlich maneuver. Willie also received an award from Red Cross for saving the life of toddler. Joan Ginther, a former professor with a PhD in statistics from Stanford University, hit the lottery four times and won nearly $21 million since 1993 after she figured out the scratch-off algorithm. Because of noise ordinance laws in Europe, club owners have created silent discos, where club goers listen to music through headphones.